Yo, what's going on, guys? It's Rez. In this video, I want to go over a brand new Amara build. That is something I definitely haven't said in a while. I know a lot of you guys have been requesting new builds, so I really hope you all enjoyed this one. And this is personally one of my favorite builds on Amara, and I highly recommend trying it out because it is super fun to play. So if you don't know, I actually made a build called Shock Trooper Amara about 2 weeks ago, and it involves all around a new interaction where Eternal Fist can actually keep reprocking active skill and anoints. And I'm actually going to use that and pair it with some new things with this build and make this into a Cryo Shatter theme build. Now, if you don't know what I mean by shatter, it's essentially just breaking ice. Now, specifically, if you saw the thumbnail, I have the Destiny characters in the background where you shatter stasis. So I was kind of going over that, like we're going to shatter cryo in this game because obviously the freezing thing in this game is cryo, whereas in Destiny, it's stasis. So I'm kind of combining the two together and making this crazy Amara build. So if you want to freeze literally everything on the battlefield and one-shot it with pretty much anything in the game, this is definitely the build for you. The mobbing on this build is where it shines the most, but you can absolutely boss with it if you want to, but I would recommend using a different setup if you're going specifically for bossing. And if you are a new Amara player, I actually have a video on my channel that I will link in the description if you need to learn all about bossing on her. Also, as always, my builds are located in my Discord channel if you'd like to download them. The link for the Discord will be in the description. If you download the build, enjoy the video, find it helpful in any way, consider subscribing and dropping a like. It's free, it really helps me out, and I truly appreciate it. With all that, I hope you guys enjoy this crazy build. All right, so starting off, I'm just going to go on and say that this build is definitely ran a lot different than most other Amara builds. So we're actually going to be taking advantage of our brand new class mod, the Kensei. As you see, we actually have +3 points and unweave rainbow. Now, the way that's going to work out is we're going to get to +6 in this. And so whenever we freeze an enemy, we're actually going to be doing 66% bonus elemental damage based on whatever our attuned element is to that enemy. So you have to do splash damage or melee damage. So we're going to be really heavily focused on splash damage weapons, or obviously you could also use your melee if you need to. And also, if you don't know the Kensei, when you activate your active skill, you get 10% bonus melee damage of her attuned active element for 6 seconds. This is essentially just bonus amp damage. So, you know, this is just a nice damage buff as well. The main thing we're using it for is the unweave the rainbow though. Now, since I was talking about splash damage weapons, I honestly just have a lot here I like to use. We have things like the plasma coil that just of course is going to be included in this, but the beacon honestly is a very, very fun option. If you don't know, the beacon is a very good pistol on its own, and when you reload this gun, it's actually going to release a nova, which will also count for killing, you know, these frozen targets a lot better. Now, the beacon itself, like I was saying, is a decent pistol which can absolutely destroy enemies, and as you see, I have a cryo version of it, which is really, really good, because if you freeze an enemy with this build, even if it's not with our main thing, which I'll get into in a second, you can freeze your enemy with this gun and just kill them with the splash damage. Now, another thing is, if you don't know, we're going to be taking 5 points in infusion because they actually fixed, you know, cryo, the axe skill element, to work with infusion. So now all our guns are actually going to be able to freeze people. So if you just have the beacon with cryo, it'll just do it better than other weapons. But just know every single gun you have can freeze people. Now, like I said, these other weapons, I just like these. The critical thug is actually very fun. If you freeze a big group of enemies, you can shoot this. It's going to do a lot of splash damage, and you're going to ricochet these other shots to do more splash damage. Head explosion is really fun as well. When you shoot with the sniper, it just causes an explosion, so you do a lot of damage into splash damage. Even things like the hellfire work with this build. I know the hellfire is a huge meme, and honestly, even with this build, it's still not the greatest, but if there was ever a build to make it work, is this build, and I highly recommend trying it out because it can be fun to actually kill people with the hellfire. So it's really good with this too. Now, like for other things, I have Sandhawks out here for bossing, same as rocket launchers, bossing and some mobbing. You know, I have a ogre right here as well, which can be very fun when you freeze people, because we're going to be getting a lot of damage bonuses and you can just melt these frozen targets. And then something like the flacker is also fun. If you just shoot it, it's going to blow a lot of things up and just shatter everything, hence the name of the build. Now, you may be asking yourself, well, Rez, how are we going to freeze people other than a fusion of something like the beacon? And that is with the frozen snowshoe. If you don't know, if you have an anoint or an axial star, any effects triggered on Shieldbreaker Field, this will just let you constantly shoot novas out around you if you use something like the Eternal Warrior action skill. So the way this shield works is when your shield is depleted, you release a cryo nova that is going to freeze enemies and heal you for 30% of the nova damage. That part doesn't matter as much, but the main thing is when you use your action skill, you're going to freeze a huge area around you, and this comes off of you, not the phase grasp. So if you're trying to freeze a specific target, you need to make sure you're running towards the enemy and be near them. So this is just a very absurd shield pair with Eternal Fist, because if you don't know, This is going to let your phase grasp just to go out to four additional targets, like I was talking about earlier. It's going to keep proccing your action skill annoyance, which is that Nova. So if you're in a very, you know, hefty room with a lot of enemies, you can have up to four Novas with this thing coming out, which is just ridiculous. And you can freeze literally the entire battlefield if you're in the right scenarios and just melt everything. Even if you just phase grasp a target and freeze that one, you can easily kill that with any of these weapons, and it's just gonna be an insta kill. Because not only are you getting the freeze damage from Unweaved Rainbow, you're also getting this class mod's bonus damage. And if you saw when I was going over all the weapons, every single anoint on these weapons are just on axe skilling to get a bonus 100% damage, because that's gonna always be proccing, because the phase grasp or the eternal fist is gonna keep proccing it over and over again on top of the Nova shield. Now for the grenade, I have a fish slap. This also is gonna do cryo, which can freeze people, but the main thing is this is actually gonna do melee damage when you throw it, which can help out with some of our skills, which we'll get into in a second. This also has an axe skilling to get 50% bonus radiation damage, which really helps with the shatter theme of this build, because when the radiation blows up, it's gonna go out and hit all the other targets, you know, to make them start taking damage and eventually blow up, and you're just gonna just have chain reactions of ice and radiation going everywhere. Now for the artifact, I have a Icebreaker Victory Rush. This is gonna give you bonus damage towards frozen targets, and you're gonna be able to freeze people easier. The Victory Rush is also gonna give you more damage and movement speed when you kill an enemy, which actually also pairs well with one of our skills that we'll get into in a second. And this is gonna give you more axe skill cooldown rate, cryo damage, and cryo efficiency. And if you was wondering on the class mod, you get splash damage, weapon damage, and axe skill cooldown rate. You don't need these, you know, exact stats on this gear. You can run pretty much whatever you wanna run. Honestly, the only thing I might recommend is axe skill cooldown rate. Since you're not running something like the Phase Arcer, that might be the most useful on this. But that is for the gear. Now getting into the skills, I'm actually going to start on Enlightened Force, because this is the main part of the skill tree. As you already know, we already went over Unweaved Rainbow. We already know how this is going to work with this build. So just to help things out with this, we're taking 5 points in Heavy Rain, so we get more projectile speed and splash damage, which means we're going to be doing more damage with our weapons because they're all splash damage. And the projectiles are going to go faster, and plus it's just going to add more damage to Unweave the Rainbow. 5 points in trusting yourself, so you get more reload speed, charge speed, and weapon slot speed when our shields are depleted. This is going to be really, really nice, because our shields can become depleted a lot, so this is actually going to give you very, very nice benefits, you know, for when you're going into battle. Now go with the flow, as the skull is talking about, that pairs well with the artifact. So when you get a kill, you get more movement speed and damage. So this is going to make it when you freeze an enemy, you get more movement speed and damage. So you freeze the enemy, you get it, then when you kill that frozen target, you get more. It's a really nice synergy. Now 1 point combo breaker, so whenever we get a melee kill, there's a 20% chance we can reset our action skill. That's where the fish slap is going to come in handy. So since that's doing melee damage, you can occasionally just get your action skill back, which is nice. It doesn't always work, obviously it's a 20% chance, but it is cool when it does. Now 5 points and burn both ends, so whenever we use our action skill, enemies start to target us more, plus we get a stacking damage buff at all times, not even when we use our action skill, and you can get up to 75% damage when you have max stacks with this. This skill also pairs very, very well with trusting yourself, because when every enemy aggroes you, you're going to lose your shield, you're going to get all these bonuses, and you're going to get a lot more damage. Now also have 3 points in body and mind, so whenever we get a kill, our melee is called splash damage. This is good for the fish slap, so it can easily get kills, and also it's good for your normal melee, because if you freeze an enemy and you have this proc, you know, you run up and do Unweaved Rainbow, you're getting bonus melee damage and splash damage on that frozen target, and you can easily just kill an enemy with one punch. Now Clear the Mon, one of Amara's best skills. This is gonna make it whenever you kill an enemy, enemies that resist elements don't resist them anymore unless they are immune to them, so you can put cryo on health, and cryo is just gonna melt as if it was just normal damage. Very, very good skill, and you have that for 8 seconds. Now Missile Assault at 3 points of fast hands, this is just to make general flow of the, you know, build better. Pairing that with trusting yourself, you have a lot of handling and reload speed, which is very, very nice. Now Fist of Elements is the next skill tree. We already went over Infusion because we're going to be trying to freeze people with the cryo. Now 3 points of steady hands, so we can handle the accuracy again, kind of like fast hands. It just makes the flow of the build better. 1 point illuminated fist, so we can convert whatever our action skill element damage is, we can convert that to our melee damage, which is going to be really, really nice, and it's going to also give you 75% more melee damage just to kill an enemy. Now 5 points of tempest will be buff for elemental damage by 30% and 20% for shock damage. Very, very nice skill for 5 points. 1 point dread, so if we kill an enemy that's phase grass, our guns are instantly reloaded, and we get 15% more damage. This is really, really good with the Eternal Fist, because if you phase grass 4 different enemies, your gun is just going to have infinite ammo while your active skill's out, because you're going to constantly be reloading it with this skill, which is very, very nice. Now 1 point deep well, so we get 20% more magazine stats for elemental weapons. Very, very nice for 1 point, plus we're trying to get down to the bottom. 1 point catharsis, again trying to get to the bottom, but this is good. So if you kill an enemy with a status effect on them. They're going to explode and do a lot of damage. 3 points indiscriminate, so whenever we shoot an enemy, all the bullets can ricochet. We all know indiscriminate is an insane perk. It makes the act clear this build very, very good, and I would highly recommend taking it in pretty much any Amara build. Then finally, 1 point sustainment, so we get health whenever we shoot an enemy with our elemental weapons. This is one of Amara's best survivability skills. It is crazy the amount of value you get for this, and all you need is 1 point in it for it to work, and that's the main thing we were trying to get down to. Now getting to the last skill tree, we have 3 points of personal space. Again, this is just gonna give you more damage the closer you are to an enemy, which is really, really nice. 2 points of Root Taraz, so we get more max health because we're trying to get down to the next skill tier where we get 5 points in Help Enhanced, so we get 40% damage reduction whenever we use our action skill. So on top of this damage reduction and the health we're getting from this, we're pretty much going to be unkillable. Then 3 points of Malfinous, so when we're taking damage, we get more movement speed and shield regeneration delay, which pairs really well with something like Burn Both Ends. And trust yourself, because you're going to be taking damage and you're getting more benefits, and it just all pairs together so nicely. The synergy of this build is crazy. You're going to be able to freeze everything, kill everything, move super quick, and it is an absolute blast to play. Alright, so that is the Cryo Shadow Amara build. Like I said, with this build, you're going to just be able to freeze everything, kill everything super quick, and it's just super fun. You don't really see Amara's new class mod being utilized that well, and this is definitely a build that's going to make it very, very good. Like I said in the beginning, my build is in my Discord channel if you'd like to download it, or if you just want to get some of the gear off, it's in there as well. But if you guys do try this out, let me know what you think. Let me know if you tweaked anything yourself to see how you changed it. I would love to know. But thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.